Tony Tano at the BHi Welland. JumpStart Jammer. In the adult division, our second time. Looking at the winners for this afternoon. First look at the women Outlaws as they come in from their semifinal match. Winners took on the women Direwolves. Played them to a 4-0 game after getting outplayed for most of the first and portions of the second half. Ball dumped right to the floor. It's brought in on the far side, rather, by the London Outlaws. Outlaws wearing the red jerseys, black numbers, occupying the home bench. Purple and yellow, LA Lakers colors. Occupying the visitors' bench is the winners. They're goaltending Matt King. He faced by Scotty McGowan for the London Outlaws. Ball final, our penultimate match here this afternoon on our JVI Sports Network coverage. Just grab me a piece of tape. Face off, they're going to bring to the left of Matt King. It's won back by Brad Campbell. All the way outside by Larry Herman. Gets worked down into the corner. Alex Kalenko is there. Kalenko for Jonah Evans. Evans took up space right in front of the crease all game in that semifinal. Look for him to work there again today. Over open side, and Larry Herman didn't miss by much. Finally, Corey Ferrugia, 87 with the blue shirts. This is Larry Herman. Will the real Larry Herman please stand up? Andrew Rager, far side, takes the shot. That one goes off the fencing and down. Jonah Evans and Rager collide on it. Ferrugia tried to center that. It's off the stick of Jack Martin. He had a great defensive game in that center final for the Rangers. No more block shots on penalty kills. So Wingers bring it down. Slapped in by Brendan Kane. That goes out the stick of the defender. Nice and low. Daffy works into the corner. Outlaws trying to bring it out. Step in with a shot. It's Kane. His first save made there by Scotty McGowan. Out. All over the line. All over the line. Played in for the Wingers. Alex Kalenko. Down in the corner, Jonah Evans. Evans kept there by Larry Herman. Ball stalled down in the corner and playing this a ball and now with the face off here to the right. Love scattered around. One back into the corner for Larry Herman. Holding up top for Brennan Crosby. Crosby whips away, outside shot. Kane drops down to make the save. Rebound into the corner. Crosby coming in for it. Evans trying to stick Kane his way away from Herman. Tried the back check, but Herman remained on the ball. Herman staying with it now. Gets bumped and fouls. Looks up for the left, no call. As here's Crosby, stopping it at the blue line. Gets it up through center. Steve Cormier. Cormier pushing it ahead up for Garrett Drouin. Drouin tries another shot. That one skims the outside of the post before ending up in behind the net. Up the wall, Curtis Gibbons. Gibbons played down by Brad Campbell. Campbell just from outside the blue line rips a shot that goes up into the screen on the far court. And the wheel light went off a winger stick, so the face off will come inside the zone. And it'll be to the right of my cane. Face off to the right of cane, Scott Russo. In on the face off. Chipped ahead by Thomas Strike. Strike giving chase, but Jeff Dupuy is there. Andrew Wager, far side. Trying to cut back. Oh, here's a shot. Looked like it was a toe save, but. In the back of the net, Andrew Wager. Passed out by Corey Ferrugia. Brad Campbell, Scott Russo, having words after that last face-off. Brad Campbell, first into the corner. Looks around the goal scorer, Andrew Wager. Inside 6 minutes to play. In the opening period, comes up outside. Oliver Wild dumps it back into the corner. Larry Holman. Comes back for Russo. He blocked the shot by Russo. Here comes Wager. Wager on the half boards. Wager tries to center, but Strike is there. Strike takes it away. Campbell whips it from the blue line for Asia. Stick handles around, Russo and Holman. Takes the shot and it's just wide. The net comes off the boards. And as Campbell touches up, the whole play to reset the cage. And that stops the clock at 5:14. Off in front of us. One here by the Oilers. Kalenko tried to chip it up but getting a stick on it. There is Garrett Druin. Druin lets Kalenko take it into the corner. And Kalenko's going to chip it up the near side. Over for Jonah Evans. The guy went down. And they say that came out Jack Martin. Trying to keep it on the right side of the blue line. Looked like it did go out, but didn't touch it. Allowed the Outlaws to bring it back out. Wingers regain possession. Can't get a shot away, though. Garrett Druin. Over it goes for Steve Cormier. Cormier and Martin in along the boards. Martin continues to push it up with one hand. It goes down into the corner for Larry Holman. Martin. Rifling the shot. Curtis Gibbons. McGowan's down. Not sure where it is. Jack Martin on the doorstep. And now McGowan's back up, working out into the slot, Brennan Kane. His shot blocked. Comes over to the near side. Hustling down the near side, Oliver Wild. Wild takes a slight bump down into the corner. Here's Evans. Backs it for Brennan Kane. Kane looking far side, Jesse Green off his stick and up into his own bench. That'll halt play with 3:55 to go. And a face-off coming to the left of Matt Kane. Jonah Evans. Dylan Gabbacourt, Curtis Gibbons, and Matt Mayer to go scores in that semifinal game of 4-0. Shutout for Matt Kane in the semifinal. For the Oilers here against the Outlaws. Pass through, Holman. Looks up at Ferrugia. Wager. Turns back for Brad Campbell. He takes a shot. That's off the leg of Evans into the corner. And they chase it back to the near side. Evans goes up over top of Campbell. Stopped in front there by Brendan Kane. Aaron down the floor, Larry Horn, gets underneath of it, tries to backhand it. Here's a little midsection of Jonah Evans, and it's high again. Left down by Corey Frugia. Stolen off his stick, though, by Brendan Kane. Stepping into a shot and in, Curtis Gibbons. Not sure if that may have hit off Jeff Dupuy. The high defender or not. But Curtis Gibbons on the go. Bit of miscommunication, trying to get it out, Larry Holman. Wasn't ready for it. They're not allowed to get on the stick of the Raiders and back to the point for a huge shot. And we're tied 1-1 inside 3 minutes to go. Working down in the corner, the Raiders sit on the stick. Scott Russo. Russo up over center. Chipped ahead. Out. Pass Matt Miller. Jesse Green goes back to play for it. Another shot and a goal. Young by the Raiders, and again an outside shot. Like Jacob Woods that time. Catching Scott in the guy. Well, the Raiders probably talked about that first period in the game against the Dire Wolves. They were vastly outplayed for the first 15, first half of that game. Had to come from behind for the victory. Worked into the corner again. This time it's Wager. Andrew Wager back for Campbell, and a glove save made by Kane. No traffic. Really in front, Corey Frugia was closing in from the far side. But Kane is able to hang on, and the faceoff will come to his left with under 2 minutes to go in the opening period now. 1 more game following this one. The vicious Alpacas will face the Punishers. We are intermediate final. This one is in the bottom division. Away from Corey Frugia. So Kalenko back to play for it. Alex Kalenko came down the near side. He gets it back after Jeff Dupuy is trying to get a shot on that. Frugia looks it down Jeff Dupuy, and then he puts it in his own net. With McGowan well up. Brad Campbell, near side, chips it off the boards. Jack Martin there as well. Gets around all of them. In for Kalenko, who just clears it. Oliver Wild, far side. Kalenko in the corner. First one there is Wild again. Wild's going to circle the net here. Kalenko spiraling in. Getting chased. Brad Campbell sneaks down the head. Short side open. Couldn't find it. Scott Russo works up far side, gets around Holman. Back in, shot and scores. What a beautiful play there back for Tom Strait. All the work done on the far side by Scott Russo. Runners jumping out early here, two goal lead. As we're now in the final minute, 45 seconds to play. Larry Horman back to get it off the face-off win. Trapping down, Brendan Crosby. Had his stick lifted at the last second, Jack Martin. They'll help this ball get out of the room. Larry Holman chases it in the corner. Curtis Gibbons. urging his team to spread out Jack Martin. He collides with Steve Cornway. He ends up working out on this side. Garrett Druin chases the ball in. Kalaika takes it away from Kane, and Kalaika has 5 seconds left to go. Should just hang around here. Bit of a late shove, Jack Martin. Gives a bump in the corner. A great first period for the Warriors on both sides of the floor. Jacob Woods, Curtis Gibbons, and Tom Strait. The goal scores, two outside shots. And a nice, pretty play down low, Tom Strait from Scott Russo. As Russo ran the far side, and bearing down again. This time Curtis Gibbons looking for his second, had Scott around down. And Rakta Popchek starts the counterattack. Kane jumps on that quickly as Gary Jones on the doorstep. Andrew Rager got things started off in this game for the London Outlaws, but 3-1 answered. Back the other way, made it 3-1. After the first period in the bottom final, the JumpStart Jammer here at BHi Welland facility on the JVI Sports Network. Coming off the half boards, Wager looking for his second, lifts it up over the head of Jeff Dupuy. Gets on net, so the Wager has to play for it. Wager, spun around that center, he's looking to the far side, point shot coming, and it's shot up and caught in the back fence. Lucky break for the Warriors there, as it looked like Brad Campbell. Ghost up, waiting for that on the round. And they'll switch up the balls, a couple on ice. Keeping them there and do soften up in the heat, because we've seen the floor soften up a little bit here, a couple of bubbles throughout the day. Quickly fixed by the BHi crew, Joe Evans. Out in front of the net, couldn't get it to settle down so he could spin and fire. This one's up on the stick of Corey Ferrugia. Ferrugia takes the shot. Tipped off the stick of Jacob Woods a little bit for going high. Matt Cain sees it all the way low. Makes the glove save. Faceoff will come to his right side. Great change here from the Warriors. They're the visiting team allowed to make it. However, Brad Campbell steps in for the faceoff, gives instruction to his line mates, and it comes straight back for Ferrugia, who takes the shot wide. Played back by Oliver Wilde, on the stick of Andrew Rager. Rager's got Kalanko on him. Ferrugia cut to the net, couldn't find it. And here comes Ferrugia. Brad Campbell's stick explodes in his hand, that's why that shot didn't go through. And there's pieces of it all over. Right in front, that shot hits off the cage, goes up into the parking lot. As they try and get all the fragments of that stick back to the Outlaw bench. Bob Campbell has a new twig, he's back on the floor. As Wager and Russo to the face-off dot. Lower Herman throws it near side for Ferrugia. Ferrugia bearing down on Kalanko. It's Kalanko in the corner. Runs it around the base of the boards. Over for Campbell. Campbell with Wager in front. Out of his reach, Russo. Has a look, it's a 3-on-2. High on Scotty McGregor, he's got to come down with it. And that stops the clock just inside of 8 minutes. still 3-1 score in favor of the Warriors. Outlaws did open the score. As McGregor gloves the face off out of midair, 7:53 now. Again, go to ballhockeyinternational.ca. Check events and tournaments. And the JBL Sports Network will be on hand to cover all of those. Next one coming up the weekend of August the 8th. We'll be on hand for the final games of that tournament. Jack Martin gives his man a bump in the corner, and he's going to sit as both arms went high. Two for body contact, I believe. Face off will come to the right of Kane. Good chance for the Outlaws now to get back in. So this one goes sky high. No one sure where it was. Rob Campbell could have run underneath, but first man there, Matt Miller. Gets into the corner, Scott Russo, the trailer. Takes a shot, it's high for McGregor. And gloved out of the way by Campbell, though. Here comes Miller, him and Garrett Druin. They battle in the corner. Druin the first one there, as is Ferrugia. Matt Miller had a look at the official after he took a bit of stick contact. He goes back for Kane. Kane behind his own net. Wagner plays on Kalaga. Backhanded up by Mike Miller, and the winner's change-up penalty kills. There's 6:45 to play in the period. Brendan Crosby. Out in front for Druin. Far side Wagner. This is where he scored his opener. Goes down low for Crosby. Backhander trying to go forehand. Rolls just away from him. Ferrugia has to chase it to the boards. Ferrugia. Far side Campbell takes the shot. And the stick save made by Kane. Pushes it into the corner. Wagner first one there. Wagner. 3-0. Is looking one timer for Ferrugia. He couldn't settle it down. In time to take the shot. Here's Ferrugia. Ferrugia off the shin guard of Russo. Grimaces behind that face mask. Ferrugia again. Russo steps up again. Over for Campbell. He has to wait for it. Takes the shot. And where is it? It's in the glove of backhand. Jack Martin is the best penalty killer for the winners in that semifinal game. He's the man that takes the penalty here. Inside of 6 minutes to play. Gloved out of midair. Maybe saving a goal was Jacob Woods. It's Ferrugia on the doorstep if he could get a stick down. That last half to touch up. It was almost a 2-on-1 shorthanded rush for the Warriors. But it just wouldn't sit for Curtis Gibbons. He's already got one in this game. Jack Martin out of the power box. Ball arrives just in time. And Oliver Wild has to play on him. Rolls away from Martin. Brendan Crosby in the corner. Here's Wager. Close the power box door for Ferrugia. Wager. Gibbons will get another attempt here. Ends up leaving. And it's Stahl on the top of the net. Hopefully he's going to come back out. McGregor. Put him in the column. Had to run after that. Off the boards and chasing Steve Cormier. Cormier collides with Jacob Woods. Get it up for Gibbons. Gibbons in front of us. It goes down. Jonah Evans. He's in. Forehand backhand. Beats Crosby to the net. And McGowan slams the goalie stick. Was done by Curtis Gibbons, a couple great shifts in succession for Curtis Gibbons, and he comes away with a beautiful assist. South, run by the Outlaws, back to the blue way. One goes sky high, Matt King comes out, right to the hash marks, makes the save. A shot. Kane drops low. Open side. He drops to his right-hand side with Ferrugia wide open. And what a save that was by Kane. Here's Russo letting one fly. Misses to the right. Tom straight. Miss it. Fresh off the box. Right in time. Matt Miller steps out as the ball arrives. Here we'll slide one up over the cage out of play. And that'll stop the clock with 3:52 on it. Score. Runners continue to extend their lead. Four different goal scorers. That's what happened in the first game. It's happened here again. In this final. On the floor for Ferrugia. Up and outside Kalenko. He takes a shot and they've hit the inside of the leg. Of Ferrugia, home. Larry Holman settles it for Brad Campbell. His shot, wind has picked up a little bit. It's running basically from the bottom of your screen across the top. Almost straight across the floor, maybe a slight right to left direction when it shows up. Much as it did last week, and what was said last week was it really carried that ball when it was shot from the right side, but if it was shot from the left side, it put a real rough turn on that ball. See if anyone can take advantage of that out here in this game when we get to our intermediate final. Round and a half boards, here come the Outlaws. Russo stuck his foot out to play on the ball. Ends up with possession as a result, but Weger steals it away, tries to get around. Kane comes out with the active stick. And it works to the far half board. Steve Cornwell there for the Outlaws. Spins it forward, stolen away, Jacob Woods. Woods look to go up through the center. The Outlaws have to touch up. Played over here, Brad Campbell whips one in. So continue their conversation that started at the face-off dot in the first. Oliver Love. Far side corner. Here they come near south. Battling around Jacob Woods. Has that one away from him. Wild brings it up through the center. He's got Chris Whitaker on his left. Can't find him though. Whitaker's going to take up residence in front of it up. Stolen by White. Tom Strait was slapped down into the corner. Rob Campbell is there. Campbell basing the boards for Larry Holman. Holman, far side, Jeff DePuy. DePuy lets it rip, and that didn't miss by much. But he's told save there by Kane. Campbell. Off the boards, Outlaws had to hold up. Steve Cornwell was offside. So streaking straight down the center, shooting just wide. Nice rush there by Damon King. No boards, they come for Cornwell again. Cornwell can't get it around Russo. Cornwell gets it back, spinning and firing. John Evans. Approaching the foul, middle of the second period now. Still 4-1. in favor of the winners. Back to Rob Campbell. Campbell looks to go around Jacob Woods. Can't, the Dupree can't keep it in. So Evans will chase him. We're on now in the final minute. As Larry Herman takes it on the half points. Up for Brad Campbell. He's looking for help. Having a hold up at the line there was Garrett Drouin. Drouin will chase it down now as Crosby can't regain possession. Over for Evans. Joel Evans sliding to his right was McGowan. Evans couldn't keep it. Brad Campbell steals that away right at mid-floor. Shot easily. Stick hand of the low, into the corner. Brad Campbell gets there first. Brendan Crosby out of his reach. Larry Herman uses the forearm. They've got to hold up. Back for Crosby. The shot there. Seen at the last minute. Dropping down this kid. Final 10 seconds. Looks like the winners are just going to allow to hold on. They came in with a 3-1 lead. But another goal by Tom Strite pushes it up to 4-1 after two periods of play. Well, hang up the hardware after 10 final 10 minutes in the bind. Gold medal final, the winners. Four different goal scorers. In the semifinal, it was Jonah Evans, Dylan Gambacourt, Curtis Gibbons, and Matt Miller. Here today, Jonah Evans, Jacob Woods, Curtis Gibbons, and Tom Strite. So we've seen 8 goals today for the winners between the semifinal and the final game. And we've seen 6 different goal scorers. Out of 10 winners on that bench. Just the one goal on the day, the opener in this game from Andrew Ryder. In the first minute and a half of the first period. Matt Kane has been solid in this tournament. At least in the afternoon. Scotty McGregor. Close on Joe Evans. Or Joe Evans, pardon me. Runs in to force the whistle. The faceoff will come to his right hand side despite the forwards asking him to keep play alive. Brendan Crosby saying he's going to take the faceoff, as will Tom Strite, captain for the Winners. Runs it back, gets away from Russo, I believe that's the intended target. And it gets out of the zone. It's Jack Martin in the zone. Now it's going to be stolen away by Corey Ferrugia. Ferrugia over for Weger. Martin's down and looks like he's hurt. Holding a hamstring. As Kane went down to hold on him. Jack Martin going to try and walk it out. Not sure if it's cramp or a pull, let me reach back for the hamstring area. Jack Martin does slowly get to the bench. Larry Herman up top in front for Ferrugia. That one hits off the foot of Russo, and you can see him grimace in behind that face mask the second time. That's happened today. So Jack Martin already down, and Scott Russo doesn't want to move very much. He's been the fast break man for the Winners here on the afternoon. Brad Campbell. Outside trying to lift it in. It's stolen by Tom Strite. And good job that Oliver Wild got stick on that, or Strite was after the races. Wild. He's in the corner. Tries to lift it up over the top of Kane. Kane goes to his right, puts the paddle down. And the right side shot from home and off the blocker into the cage. And here's Strite. Strike with Roger on him. Roger up for Campbell. Scotty Russo having a bit of fun with the camera. As the play comes right in front of us, 7:47 to go. in the third period. Crouch in for the faceoff. Run it so clear, it went right back for Jeff Dupuy, his quick shot. There's the length of the floor. Matt Kane had to shuffle right. That one's going to hit the upright stanchion. And they'll call that icing as it came down. Still just the 4-1 score. Cloud cover starting to roll, blocking the sun a little bit, and nice little breeze. No gusts like we had last week, but with the sun released in hiding. It's cooled off ever so slightly. Looks like there's a problem with the floor over there in the corner. Scott Russo and referee Chad Asseltine. Go to work that out. Looks like the kink is settled down. This gives everyone a chance to go grab some water. Grab a quick breather. And chance for us to remind you. Coming up following this game, our final game of our coverage here on the JBI Sports Network, the intermediate final, the Vicious Alpacas. Coming into the game, thanks to a 4-1 victory over the Throwbacks, they'll face the Punishers in our intermediate final. That one coming up later this game, but we're on the bound division right now. Faceoff coming to the right of Matt Kane. Immediately to the half boards. Jesse Green in there. Green goes right to that spot where they were working. Bob Campbell back for Jeff Dupuy. His shot went off the blocker of Matt Kane, off the pipe. He wasn't sure where it was. Had a quick look. Steve Cormier, they couldn't find the handle. Here's Dupuy up top. He tries again. That went off the foot of Russo. That's the third time in this game Russo's blocked a shot off the foot. Here comes Russo. Strike, gave chase. Dupuy took it off the cage in the ground. Spun it through, here's Bob Campbell working in. He looked for the top corner, it was off the shoulder of Kane, who dropped down Butterfly. In the corner, having a look, Curtis Gibbons. Gibbons is going to play it off the boards. Russo giving chase, icing waved off. Russo, Jeff Dupuy there as well. Larry Holman. Out in front, Jonah Evans was there. McGowan was screaming for someone to go cover Evans. Doesn't result in anything. Over the blue line, here's Russo, takes a shot just wide. They're off the backboards. Now Russo's going to head off. Trying to complete a change here for the Warriors. Far side. Can't sit for Campbell. Jonah Evans, it works out over the blue line here. Looking for Garrett Jordan. Up for Gibbons again. Gibbons looking to spray Evans. Now Gibbons is going to go straight through the middle. Here comes the shot. Poke check up in the logo there on the ground. Nice save and a nice play. Gibbons and Evans working. Jonah Evans, the recipient of some good passes so far and some good footwork. Curtis Gibbons had a great setup earlier on the Joe Evans goal, and Scott Russo has been the setup guy. Jump ball, Joe Evans uses his size to get up there, bats it back down. Curtis Gibbons first into the corner. Evans is going to chase it as it returns back in behind the net. Gibbons spins and fires, doesn't miss the low far corner by much. As Corey Fury is going to settle it down. Oliver Wilde has to give chase. Back up top for Curtis Gibbons, off the glove, goes high into the cage, and Jeff Dupuy is there. Dupuy for Wild again. up over center, Jack Martin. He's going to go through the legs for DePee. Here's Crosby, Ferrugia, Martin goes low and they can't get it up over the stick. You can see Martin still moving slowly after he went off with what looked like a hamstring injury. Quick shift from Martin again. There's Jonah Evans, but McCallum's down and Gibbons can't find any part of the open cage there. Ferrugia, down the far side, Jesse Green. He hangs up. Here's Ferrugia again. Through the middle, out of the round. Middle, Jonah Evans. Wagger waits for his teammates to get onside. Wagger from the half boards, dumps it to an empty spot. Ferrugia turns and fires, and that's him in the midsection of King. And he hangs on. 4.5 minutes to play in this barn final matchup. Face off controlled here by the winners. Off the boards, giving chase, Matt Miller. Stolen by Wild. Goes up for Wagger. Wagger touched it right at the blue line. Russo keeps it alive. Straight. Chases into the corner. Charles Green. Green steps into it in the shot and stick save. Tunnel English, I don't know, I believe the guy was trying to put it in the corner. It ended up just hanging on. Ferrugia spins and fires, and that one, English takes that into the half boards. Ferrugia deep in the corner now. He's got Wagner with him. Ferrugia stepping out, takes the shot. And now Karanka. Spinning quick, it's Crosby. Kane was down, and that one just went wide. Here's Ferrugia. Ferrugia trying to get off. Almost too many men as he was hustling up. And Brad Campbell came in, following in front of Campbell was Matt Miller. Miller gets up. Here's Larry Harney and trail official Chad Asseltine makes the call, and I believe Brad Campbell's going here as Matt Miller heads to the bus. Brad Campbell throws the stick in disgust, slams the door as well, and coming over to serve, Chris Whitaker. Has taken a couple shifts in this game. Well, we haven't seen much of him is on the game sheet. He can go over to serve. Steve Cormier. Comes over to have a word. Jack Martin and Matt Miller now apparently down for the winners. Kane's got a drop. Make that save, 2:54. There's this one chipped in, Kolenko. In on the ground, sends it to the corner. Strike. Trying to get the stick on, it's short-handed. All right, the Outlaws now with a big hill to climb in the final 2.5. Jeff DePee keeps it alive. Pinching in through center. Jacob Woods steals. Up for Brendan Kane. Kane up for Woods, tries to get the glove on it. Just can't get it to stop hopping. And he comes back up again. Russo. Warriors are the team on the power play as Russo takes it back up. And on the near side, Brendan Kane. Looking at ISO, Brian Fino, already leading 4-1. loose and straight. Far side, playing catch. Here's Brendan Crosby. Whips in here, it goes wide. As Green gets chased, Steve Cornwell there as well. Green and Cornwell tied up in front of the bench. Now the Ringers player falls. Crosby comes after the ball. Crosby looking the center of the floor. His backhand shot got in on that. Steve Cornwell looked for the rebound. Straight up through center, Russo holds the line, Jonah Evans. They'll help out near side. It sneaks under the armpit. Didn't quite catch over the line. The initial shot coming from Brendan King and Scott Russo, the trailer. There to finish up, and the fifth different goal scorer, if it goes to Brendan King or Scott Russo, it'll be the fifth different goal scorer in the game. Neither Russo or Kane had a goal in that semifinal either. So out of the 9 goals we've seen now, 7 goal scorers for the Ringers out of 10 runners. Jack Martin back on the floor. He's just going to backpedal into the corner in the final minute here. No need to force the issue in double matter. Probably this is the power play for the Ringers. Up 5-1 here. Joe Evans, Scott Russo, Jacob Woods, Curtis Gibbons, and Tom Strait. Goal scorers, it started with Andrew Lager. It looked like it was going to be a pretty good match back and forth, but the Ringers, as they did in the semi, got momentum and never relinquished it. Brendan King straight through the middle. And Curtis Gibbons with his second of the game. And Oliver Wilde found the loose ball and shot about halfway to St. Catherine, so he's picked up an unsportsmanlike matter. But the officials are just going to keep the clock winding down. That'll do it for our bond final. The winners, they're the winners. As there is the home run and Outlaws coming away with just one goal from Andrew Wagner. Joe Evans, Scott Russo.